Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to make this little project you see on the screen, this animated fly-through effect in Fusion. Start out an edit page. As usual, go to media pool, right click, new Fusion composition. We'll change it to 10 seconds. You can name it if you like, but you don't have to. Bring down your timeline and go to Fusion. I did make up a little cheat sheet here to help us get through this a little faster. So we'll go back to this from time to time, probably, unless I do remember them all the way through. Click away right about here. Shift spacebar. And S star. Put that viewer one. Go up to points, we'll put it on 3. On the border width, 0.001. And uncheck solid. Come down here to width and height, right click on the width, expression, click on this little plus sign, drag the quick whip over to the height and let go. Now they'll move symmetrically. Set that at 0.6. And let's name it triangle. Click away right about here and shift spacebar. Now we want S ellipse. Put that in viewer one. And border width, 0.001 again. On the width and height, right click the width. Put expression. Set that at 0.27. And uncheck the solid. Click away down here. Shift spacebar. And S star again. Change the points to 5. Let's put that in the viewer one. And a border width, 0.001. Right click on the width again. And set that to 0.24. And uncheck the solid. Click away right about here and shift spacebar. And extrude. Take the subdivisions all the way to the right. And same thing with the smoothing angle. Excursion depth of 0.025. And take the bevel, both bevels, to 0.0063. I right click on the extrude, copy, click away, right click, and paste instance. Go below that, click away, right click, and paste another instance. Put the merge in viewer one. Click the merge, add another one, camera, and a render. Connect the render and the media out. For those of you that don't know what an instance is, it's a copy of whatever node you took it off from. And it'll have a little green line connecting the two together. And everything that's highlighted in green indicates if you change that value, it'll change it in whatever it's connected to by way of the green line. So we're gonna de-instance some things of both these, the X, Y, and Z. So right click, and de-instance. An X, Y, and Z, right click. Now they're decoupled. Now we'll do this one. It's like the camera node. Under translation, Z axis, right click the Z, modify with, anim curves. Now I have this little modifier up here. Select that. Throw my cheat sheet up here. On the scale, we want 1.5. The offset, 1.7. The time scale, 0.85. Then we're going to change our focal length. So go back to Tools, Controls. We'll change the focal length from 35 to 40. Okay, let's look at the merge. Select that merge there. translation, Z-axis, 1.0, and a scale 0.25. Okay, we'll bring a shader down, we'll put some chrome on it. Go over to effects. Templates. Fusion. Shaders. Bring the chrome down. Okay, connect it to each one of these green inputs. Now we have chrome on it. I'm going to use the loader to bring my picture in. That way it will stay with the project. You can bring it in from the media pool as well, but if you decide to save it, it won't keep the picture in. So shift spacebar. Type in loader. Then an image plane. Connect that into there. And put that in viewer one. That looks correct. Go back to the original extrude node. Under transform. Triangle. We're going to rotate under rotation, y-axis. So right click on the Y, modify with, anim curves. Now we have this little modifier up here. We're going to change this 180 to 360. Now the triangle will rotate 360 during this full length of this timeline. Now we'll go to the ellipse, the ring. Under transform, rotation, x-axis, right click on the x. Modify with, anim curve. And again, got another modifier up here. Change the 180 to 360. Now we just want to rotate the star. Select the bottom instance. Under rotation, Z-axis, right click, modify with, anim curve. Once again, go to modifier, change it from 180 to 360. Put your playhead at frame 150 or you have to adjust it accordingly if you have a different frame rate. I am on 30 frames per second. You want to be halfway through your timeline. Select the camera node. Select use target. Now under the target, x-axis. Make sure it's set at 0, set a keyframe. Go all the way to the end. You can see in viewer 1, okay, with the camera node selected, open your spline. We just want the target selected and select all and smooth. Let's do one other thing. Make sure your render node selected. Change the render type from software to hardware. That'll render out much faster. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one.